prodigiously talented junior athlete, Steve Ovett emerged as a senior in 1974 when, undeterred by a recent bout of glandular fever, he won his first Triple A's title, the 800 metres.
Number 18 next, Steve Ovett, who's only 18, the European junior champion. Then Andy Carter, the reigning champion. Byron Dice, number 28 of Jamaica. Vincent Reid of America, number 26. Okay. McMeekin of Scotland, number 16. And Colin Campbell of Polytechnic Harriers, right on the outside. The first 110 metres run in lanes, and the battle for the inside position already on. McMeekin's gone off very quickly indeed, and so too has Vincent Reid of the United States. And into the back straight now, and they break in about 20 yards. Holding the curb on the inside is John Greatrix. Vincent Reid comes across from the outside. Vincent Reid leads for America. McMeekin of Scotland in second place. Greatrix is third, right up on the inside. And Steve Ovett right at the back with Byron Dice of Jamaica. Into the back straight with 300 to go, and it's McMeekin leading for Scotland. Vincent Reid, America, second. Campbell, third. Pete Brown, fourth. Carter moving up on the outside with Byron Dice of America. Ovett struggling at the moment with Greatrix dropping right back. Just over 200 metres left. Still the American in front, and Byron Dice cruises through into second place for Jamaica. Campbell is third. Carter, four. McMeekin, five. And Peter Brown going up, and Ovett still made no move. The young European junior champion, but coming hard round the outside, just out of the picture. Number 18. A tremendous piece of acceleration by Ovett, who may have left it too late. Vincent Reid leads for America. Dice second for Jamaica. Carter third for Great Britain. Campbell fighting through, and Ovett coming on the outside. The teenager with a tremendous late run. And it's Carter down, Ovett. And Ovett takes it down in the last seven strides. Ovett wins. Carter second. Dice third. Vincent Reid fourth. What a piece of composed and organised running by this boy, Steve Ovett, from Brighton and Hove. Right in the back, he seemed to have left it too late. Move round the outside, round the back, top bend. Attacked off the bend, knew exactly what he was doing, and as the others faded, he came through to clock an unofficial time of 1:46.8. He left it terribly, terribly late.
18 following number one. This is the boy recovering from glandular fever that has to restrict the amount of racing that he's doing, but here in superb form. Weather conditions not favorable, but look at this for a punishing burst across the line. Andy Carter going with him has sensed him to his right. Steve Ovett at 18 showing a maturity well beyond his years. Byron Dice with all his international experience and Mark Winton Reid are back in the wake of this young man. What a find he is.
So Ovett adds to his European Junior Championship his first major senior title, 3A's champion at only 18.
As the bad boy of British athletics against the more clean-cut co, Ovett displayed the fiery side to his character after this semi-final victory at the 1979 Triple A Championships. Ovett's bad boy image was cultivated by many sports writers at the time because he was often less than cooperative with the media.
All interest in the man in second place, Steve Ovett. The controversial international who's been cruising along in second place. Third is Norris of New Zealand. Moving up on the outside is Grant of Wales. In fifth place, Empson of Tipton. Williams goes up on the outside for Cambridge. Right there is Harvey as well. But look at the kick in front. And with four to qualify, this man surely away on his own. The European 1500-metre champion making it look supremely easy. It's a slow race. This familiar salute to the crowd. How they love it. And how they love to see him running at home. He moves right across the track. He's way, way out now in lane six. He wins it. Empson in second place. Williams and Norris are third and fourth. Those are the qualifiers. But there was only one man they were watching, and how they enjoyed him.
Ovett won at a canter here, but in this rare interview, and with the Moscow Olympics looming, it was politics as well as sport on his mind.
Well, I think over the last 3 weeks, David, it's been, I think, sheer bloody mindedness on my part that's carried me through the bad organisation from our governing bodies. I think if it had been anybody else of a lesser calibre, shall we say, in far as character was concerned, I think they would have succumbed to the pressure that was put upon them. And I must admit that over the last 3 weeks, I've been doing more arguing in the political side of the sport than actually training. And I don't think that can be good for any athlete.
In the final the following day, Ovett trailed the unfancied Kevin Steer, who had set a breathtaking pace.
Steve Ovett has made no move, and he's not going to be the man to take them. He said that quite clearly then. And this could be a rare defeat for Steve Ovett, because he's got a tremendous amount of running to do, and so too has everyone else. Leading the chase now is Alan Madison of Stretford, and the crowd warming to Kevin Steer. But what a battle he's going to have on the last lap, because his legs are giving out. Modisette in second place, Owen is third, Williamson four, Robson five, Empson six. They go through the bell, they've still got 20 to 25 metres to take out of him. Now, what can Owen do about a lead like this? Certainly Steyer will tire on the last lap. 300 metres left, the crowd willing him along, but they're now eating him up with every stride. 2.56 he ran for three quarters, and there goes Ovid now down the back straight. And Steve Ovid has eaten the gap up. He's absolutely swallowed him. 200 metres left, and he made up 20 metres in 100. Ovid leads, and the rest now nowhere. Williamson in second place. Robson is third, Empson four. And Steyer, well, he's gone right back through the field. Ovid comes home in front, and now he's got a fan club that rises in the stand to wave handkerchiefs. He's just controlling the race from the front. Williamson in second place takes that from Robson, who finishes third. Fourth is Modisette. In fifth place, Downs. Next is Empson. And then Malcolm Plant. And in fact, Steyer has been congratulated by Ovid immediately. And Steve Ovid, well, I've never seen him show bad sportsmanship at any stage in his career. He's always the first to respect someone who's done his best. And Steyer made a fast race possible. The others didn't want it. But having said that, Steyer through three quarters of a mile approximately in 2.56. But what a piece of running down the back straight from Steve Ovid.
We rejoin Yvette a few months later in August 1979 for this 4x800m world record attempt at Crystal Palace. Despite fielding a strong lineup, the home nation's hopes were hung around one man's neck. England and Yvette are Team A, Belgium Team B, Nigeria are Team C, and Team D are a composite team.
Steve Ovid waits at the halfway stage at this 4x800m. Coming into him, Dane Joseph, and running a good leg. Chris Sly ran the first leg, Dane Joseph the second leg, now Steve Ovid the third, and if a British record is to be on, it's to be on now with this solo run by Steve Ovid. They're now 12 yards clear of the Belgian team with Heron Gorosch, a 149 man, whereas Ovid at his best could break the back of this race, and indeed this British squad, which really is a in itself a composite team, could break the British record of 7 minutes 14.6, an average of 149.5 per leg. Steve Ovid, who wanted a quiet season, enjoying this as a sharpener, has seen the first two. Chris Sly ran 149.5 and Dane Joseph 149. And although this is a race not often run, it really has a remarkable history as far as Britain's concerned, because back in June 1966, the UK national record was set at 4x800 by Graham Grant, Mike Varra, Chris Carter and John Bolter. And in actual fact, they beat the Soviet Union and West Germany at that time over 4x880 yards, being a slightly longer race. And they sliced 3 seconds off the then world record. And the IAAF banned it as a world record because a British coach called out the wrong time at the end of the first lap for the anchor man, John Bolter. John Bolter, incidentally, former, still holds the British record for 1,000 metres. So we were robbed of what might have been a world record. And that time of 7 minutes 14.6 was one of the great inaugural races of the Crystal Palace National Sports Centre opening up. But here's Steve Ovid. He ran 52 seconds for the first 400 metres of the 800 metres. And this is a nice casual run. It looks as though he's out to run a steady leg. He's going to hand over to Rob Harrison, and I'm sure that there's a lot of people here delighted to see him because he's been much maligned in the press recently, and most of it totally unworthy. Run 3:54.9 for a mile yesterday and comes here to run a very good leg in this 4x800m.
England didn't quite break the record, but 24-year-old Yvette had more pressing matters to attend. Yvette's Olympic homecoming was the centenary mile at Crystal Palace. He was looking to complete a fine season with another victory. We pick it up in the final lap of Heat 2.
Steve Yvette in second place. He's the strong man in this heat. Third is Sean Cahill. Then Alan Modisette in fourth place. Graham Fell is fifth. Sixth on the inside is Stan Markley. I'm moving it up on the outside. Looks like Jerry Van Dyke of America. But the leader, Ovette, now by himself. He's got clear of all the trouble. In fact, he was never in trouble. Just looking round, it's so easy, isn't it? And tremendous race for the places, and there's going to be quotes with six to qualify. In second place behind Ovet, Sean Kyle. Third on the far side is Fell. Bottershead's also a qualifier. So too is Mike Downs. And it looked as if Alan Bottershead was there as well.
Here he is the following day in the final, finishing the job and rounding off a spectacular season. Among his competitors were the great Kiwi John Walker, Olympic gold medalist in 1976.
Walker followed by Steve Ovett. So Walker leads, Steve Ovett in second place, and Steve Flint, the Intercounties champion, third, only 19 from Northampton. Moving up on the outside, in the darker vest, Keith Rothwell of Stretford. Settling down to a fairly leisurely pace. It's been a hard season for both Walker and Ovett, but especially Ovett. He's had so many races, and really, he's dominated this event. In the last 4 years, just one defeat in 51 races so far. I say what, in the last 4 years? It should be the last 3 years, since May 77, when Steve Scott beat him. He's only had one defeat at 1,500 metres in the mile since then, in 51 starts. A spear moving up on the outside, trains with Steve Ovett, both coached by Harry Wilson. 3 minutes, 12 seconds at the bell. Walker livening it up slightly, but nothing decisive yet. Ovett follows in second place. A spear is third. Steve Flint fourth, and there goes a spear on the outside, and suddenly it's begun to happen. And a front 300, Ovett takes it up. He normally doesn't go that far out, but he really has hit the front now. And he approaches the 200 mark with a 3-4 metre lead from John Walker. A spear is next. Alan Bottershead in fourth place. And Ovett now stretching clear, but Walker trying to close the gap. But Ovett really moving into top gear. Walker chasing hard. A spear third, reaches fourth. But Ovett comes home and celebrates on the way in his final race of the season to take the centenary title. Walker in second place, reaches third, a spear four, Bottershead five, and in sixth place was Tim Hutchins of Crawley. And Ovett bows to the crowd. The end of a marvellous season.
Ovett's ILY t-shirt stood for the words "I love you," three letters that would become a trademark of his career and were directed at his beloved girlfriend Rachel. At this stage, Ovett was at the peak of his powers. He was a double Olympic medalist, European champion, and then in 1982 he received an MBE. In 1983 to finish fourth in the 1500 metres at the World Championships, here he is in action later that year at the Bislett Games in Oslo.
Ovett now with about 6 metres to spare from Gonzalez. In third place is Ray Flynn. And in fourth place, 20 years old Steve Crabb from Enfield. Fifth at the moment is Christofferson. And the time at the bell, 2:37.36, is quick. And they're closing slowly on Ovett. This will be a test of his fitness. Ovett leading with 300 to go, Gonzalez second, Ray Flynn is third. Ray Flynn hard at racing, winning the 5,000 to the 3A's championship. And young Steve Crabb of Enfield running the race of his life in fourth place. He's having a marvellous run. 200 to go, and still Ovett holding the curve. Can he kick from the front like Coe did? And Flynn comes up on the outside. It's Ray Flynn now, the all red. Ray Flynn of Ireland, Ovett holding the curve, going the short way, checks to see who it is, and tries to kick off the bend. What's he got left? And he's got enough. He comes away gradually, but Gonzalez on the inside. I don't know that he's seen him, but he's strong enough possibly to hold him. Gonzalez closing, he's not seen him, has he? He's done it enough. Ovett wins, Gonzalez second, Flynn third, Crabb in fourth place. And in fifth place, a Mirageau of France. The time, very, very fast indeed, 3:34.49, and that is the third fastest time in the world this year.